Krishnani begane baro Krishnani begane baro Krishnani begane baro Krishnani begane baro Krishnani begane baro.
A padam is a song from South India. It talks about love, sometimes spiritual, sometimes sentimental, sometimes affectionate, as you just saw in a glimpse of the padam Krishnani Begani Baro, in which the singer and the dancer speak to the child god Krishna. Padams and the art of singing expressively and dancing expressively are a language for communicating emotional essences. The rapport between the audience, the singer, and the dancer depends very much upon a common reservoir of almost unconscious knowledge. The child or god Krishna is to some a god, is to some a child, but is familiar to almost everyone on the subcontinent with its own history, myths, philosophies. And such is the nature of the various arts and philosophies that view and have viewed Krishna for ages and ages, such a diverse amount of art forms, that everyone is free to conceive of and relate to Krishna in the way they want to. This padam, most padams are in four of the South Indian languages. One of the four South Indian languages. This one was in Kannada. For a Kannada speaker, they would pretty much understand the entire text. A South Indian from another part of South India would understand partially the text, and people from all over the subcontinent would most probably understand some of the key words. Likewise, with the music, the structure of the music is such that, of course, being completely clear to a South Indian musician or concert goer is also instinctively felt by many people all over India, because the substratum of the music tallies well with so many of the musical forms in all the other regions. And the facial expressions and the dance language also would speak, of course, very clearly to any practitioner of the South Indian dance form, Bharatnatyam. But also, practitioners of other Indian dance styles would have a fairly good idea of what's being said. And even those who don't know much would instinctively feel many of the iconic pan-Indian gestures and ideas that are being expressed through the padam. As a child, I yearned to visit other worlds. I had a secure childhood in Midwestern America in the 50s and 60s, and I was allowed to travel to other worlds by spending my time with poetry, paintings. I played piano, I secretly danced when no one was around. But I still yearned for something beyond the homogeneity of Midwestern America. In fact, I don't think I saw a person of another color until I was perhaps a teenager. And when I did, it was a pleasant shock. When I was an adolescent, I met a piano teacher who has been the first out of two major influences in my life. Her reputation was so subversive that I had to visit her in secret without my parents' knowledge. And indeed, she was dangerous, as she opened up vistas of ancient history, philosophy, world literatures, good, wholesome food, and all this with an amazing generosity of spirit and a desire to nurture her students. I first saw Bharatanatyam in Golden Gate Park in San Francisco, and I think when I first saw it, I perhaps missed the incredible sophistication of its synthesis of various art forms, but I was struck by what I felt was its organic feeling of, first from the striking of the bare feet to the integral use of every part of the body, to the intriguing and tantalizing language of gestures that was used. Coming to India was, on the surface, very impulsive, with the sole desire of learning Bharatanatyam. But I think underneath the surface was the desire that I had nurtured from the time I was a child to visit other worlds. My first impression of India was actually the quality of the light. As I got down from the plane, the sunlight suddenly was so strikingly different from the geography I was used to. And that light continued to play on the fields and then glisten on people's skin in a way that I had never known before. Of course, many were my impressions when I first came, but I think the two most lasting impressions I have that I had from the very beginning were, firstly, the close proximity in which people from all different classes and communities lived in very intimate physical space. And I still hold today that that is one of the most positive aspects of this country. The other was, at that time at least, simple phrases like simple living and high thinking were prevalent. I think they were perhaps still there in the air from the heady days of post-independent India. And I identified with them very much, Gandhian principles. And I think even today, they are perhaps, though rather neglected, our most effective weapons against things like globalized consumerism. As far as learning dance goes, and as everyone always says, adapting to another culture, apart from the physical pain I went through, the adaptation was not very difficult for me. These days, there's a great emphasis put on something called the Guru Shishya Parampara. Everyone talks about it. No one talked about it when I first came and learned. And I think maybe a lot of undue emphasis is given upon its form rather than its content. Because I think an ideal teacher-student relationship, which is what is meant by the term Guru Shishya Parampara, can come out anywhere. It requires a teacher who is generous in spirit and a student who has the desire to learn. And that generosity isn't completely selfless, because the teacher also is in it because they want to transform themselves just as much as a student wants to transform themselves. After the training period was over, I was finally faced with some issues of culture and identity because I wanted to stay on in India. I had never ever had the desire to leave, actually. So I decided to take Indian citizenship. And even though I firmly believed from a very early age that we are universal citizens, at least if we have the privilege of being one, and that we're free to move anywhere and interact with anyone, it still was a moving experience to relinquish American citizenship and to become a citizen of the world's largest democracy. And I think that is a tribute to both these democracies. And along with relinquishing one citizenship and acquiring another, I felt and still feel a great sense of responsibility as a citizen to continue contributing to such a society so that it remains democratic in its nature. And the way I have chosen to do that is by being a teacher myself, and I combine both music and dance, I teach both. And my main effort as a teacher is to infuse students who are willing to learn the enthusiasm that I feel for all the arts, both at an international level and at a multi-art level. And to continue doing this in the right spirit, I quite often come against perceived hierarchies and notions which seem quite fixed and somewhat isolationist in their attitude towards the arts. So it is my constant endeavor to get people to think about the connections between arts, to fight against notions of high and low culture, urban and rural culture, staunchly defined linguistic groups, staunchly defined genres. And one way I do this is by constantly looking at history, engaging with history, which is something which many people in the arts today are very reluctant to do. But I see no harm in, just as we try to understand and tolerate each other, why not look into history, look at our temporal neighbors in history, look at them straight in the face, don't flinch from uncomfortable truths about where the arts may have come from. And with that embracing of history, you feel a renewal, definitely, in the arts today. And this is the way I feel that the arts will survive. So now I would like to complete the padam that I started just now, Krishna Nibegane Baro, with Shreya Muthukumar singing.
Krishna Nibegane Baro, 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 Begane Baro, Mukhavanna Toro, Begane Baro, Mukhavanna Toro, Begane Baro, Mukhavanna Toro, Krishna Nibegane Baro, Kalalandu Gegeje Nilada Bavoli, Kalalandu Gegeje Nilada Bavoli, Nilavarna Ninatya Vaduta Baro, Nilavarna Ninatya Vaduta Baro, Krishna Nibegane Baro, Kashi Pitambara Kayalli Kolala, Kashi Pitambara Kayalli Kolala, Pusida Shri Gandha Mayola Gamma, Pusida Shri Gandha Mayola Gamma, Krishna Nibegane Baro, Taige Bayalli Taige Bayalli Taige Bayalli Jagavan Torida Taige Bayalli ಜಗವನ್ನು ತೋರಿದ ಜಗದೋಧಾರಕನಮ್ಮ ಉಡುಪಿ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಜಗದೋಧಾರಕನಮ್ಮ ಉಡುಪಿ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ನೀ ಬೇಗನೆ ಬಾರೋ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ ನೀ ಬೇಗನೆ ಬಾ